City within a city. 1931, and first plans are made for Rockefeller Center. Six architects were employed by the Rockefeller interests to design the buildings which are to cover several blocks in the heart of Midtown Manhattan. Parent of the project, John D. Rockefeller, about to inspect the completed RCA building, built in less than 2 years. This structure was started July 1931 and finished in May 1933. $74 million in buildings. This is Rockefeller Center.
The Rockefeller Center was the largest private building project undertaken in modern times. It's actually a combination of two complexes, the original 14-building Art Deco development and a later quartet of international-style towers built in the 1960s and 70s. Though conceived as a profit-motivated real estate venture, John D. Rockefeller Jr., the philanthropic son of the original oil baron, had a keen interest in music, the arts, and uplifting philosophies. The setback open spaces on the plaza inadvertently served a kind of public service as a town square for New York.
Christmas Day, this is the place to be. You cannot walk through here on Christmas morning. Everybody wants to be in Rockefeller Center. It's just where New Yorkers know they should be. Not just because of the tree, because it's the center of town.
There's one towering skyscraper that clearly dominates the complex. I've heard it referred to as 30 Rock.
30 Rock is 30 Rockefeller Plaza. It's the 70-story skyscraper at the heart of the center.
The Rockefellers' benevolent way with artists erupted in scandal in the 30 Rock lobby when the artist Diego Rivera painted an enormous, politically controversial mural that included a portrait of Lenin and decadent capitalists boozing it up. He refused to change it, and it was soon painted over with a new mural that you can still see today by Joseph Maria Sirt, entitled American Progress. What was the idea behind the commissioning of so many artists to display in public areas?
Today we would say Rockefeller was searching for meaning, or the people around him. Give it a spiritual aspect. They hired a philosophy professor, Professor Alexander, to come up with themes for Rockefeller Center, and the artwork reflects some of those themes. On the other hand, Rockefeller was also no fool, and he knew that famous artists would attract attention and would help attract attention to his complex, and therefore people would rent space in it. So it's really those two sides.